Drove myself today, Jeff.
That was the most comfortable ride I've ever taken.
Christina here?
I don't know. I haven't seen her.
Where is she at? That was literally the worst scare.
Wow. I found this Harmony rock. Hopefully we get harmony with this house we haven't seen. I even wore all my special crystals.
All right, let's do it.
So this is a 4-bedroom, 3-bath, 2,300 square foot tri-level house. That fountain is nasty.
So I've seen houses are actually really fun to buy and really scary to buy because it's like gambling, you know? You don't know what you have. So the first time you open that door, it's either like a home run or it's an oh crap moment. Ooh, cat house. Good news, no step down. All right, so it's literally the worst kitchen ever.
It's so awkward that they even put this like kitchenette in here. Like this is never gonna be a $1 million kitchen, no matter how much money we put into it. It's tiny.
If we open it up, it will be.
If we open it up, it will be, but not at this layout. It's horrible.
I already know we would wanna open this up.
You're talking about these two walls right here?
Yeah.
Oh, dude. That means that there would be no post here holding anything up?
Let's get the architect and engineer out here.
Yeah, okay. That's the best idea.
All right, let's keep going. Oh, I really dislike tri-level homes, but this is not a bad tri-level. Tri-level floor plans are really, really difficult to work with because tri-level floor plans are dated. Buyers want big open spaces. And with a tri-level, you have a bunch of different stairs running into different levels, making it pretty hard to come up with a design that works throughout.
What do we got down here? Closet?
Downstairs bathroom on this side.
Oh, there's a shower down here. Okay, here's the problem. The rooms are super small, super dark. It is not a good start.
It's like a dungeon.
What?
Stop it. Oh my gosh, okay. I'm not loving the house so far.
Let's go upstairs, yeah, let's do that. Ooh, look.
That's horrible. This place just keeps going.
Oh, what a weird bedroom.
Oh, no. It seems like this was some type of weird add-on.
Hey, Jeff, kitchen is here.
Uh-oh.
Yep.
Okay, so we really need to get an architect out to see what we can do because the house is awful with that kitchen.
Bedroom two?
This is a tiny bedroom for a friggin' $900-something-thousand-dollar house.
Oh. Bathroom? Oh, man. Yuck.
Got this whole thing, right?
Yeah, full gut.
You're looking at 6,300. If we have to rerun the plumbing and everything, 66.
Let's go look at the master.
It seems like someone punched a hole in the door. Any idea?
Well, yeah, they probably got mad because this house is so big they couldn't figure out how to redesign it. I'm surprised there aren't more holes.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of rooms here. I feel like every time I turn around, there's another room that needs to be redone.
Yeah, this house is gonna be a beast to remodel. Hopefully the master's big. Huge master bedroom.
This is a big room with really high ceilings, and it's still so dark in here. Why?
This glass has tint on it.
It's a little lighter, but look, it's weird. There's no ceiling lights.
There's a light right there.
Yeah, there's a light.
Light. Dang.
Look at your favorite, a walk-in closet.
Okay.
Dude, your closet's bigger than the bathroom.
Wow, this is a terrible bathroom. Look at the vanity, the light, the shower. Ooh, it's bad. How much are we looking at in here?
Give me at least $7,500.
This house needs a lot of work.
Overall, figure on about 72.
So 72 without the backyard?
Right.
Okay. The expenses on this tri-level house are really adding up. But we're putting our money into two areas that I think will give us the best chance of selling the house. The kitchen and the master suite. If those areas come out amazing, I think we have a chance of making some real money.
So, I know we have spent a ton of money here on all sorts of items. However, we still cannot overlook this fireplace. So here's what I suggest. This for the hearth and this for the rest, and then big chunky mantle.
Like a wood mantle?
Yes.
I mean, it's not gonna be cheap.
For under $2,000, we'll have a beautiful fireplace.
Okay, it'll look good.
Perfect, that was easier than I thought it would be.
Hey.
Hey.
It's the biggest shower we have done in 9 years. This used to be a walk-in closet. It was completely dead space.
This thing's massive.
So we're not even gonna have a door there. It's just a walk-in shower.
So what are those?
These are for the body sprayers.
It's gonna be super cool.
Design-wise, maybe doing the white subway on this wall and that wall, and then doing this entire wall, like an accent wall with one of these three.
Okay.
I really like this one.
But overall, I like the pattern. What are you thinking for the shower pan?
What if we took this tile and just ran it through the shower floor and up this wall?
That's way too much of that pattern. What if we just did the white subway throughout, all the walls?
We spent a fortune expanding the shower, and to throw a boring white subway just makes no sense.
Well, what if you just did this, but not the whole wall? And then you could do on the floors too.
Like a big band coming down the middle?
Doing a band in the middle so you can still see it, but so it's not so massive will look really good.
What do you think, 3 feet wide?
Yeah. What do you want to do around it?
Maybe we do like more of a modern 12 by 24 bright white?
Yeah, look good.
So question, in the hall bathroom, maybe we do something a little simpler.
Oh.
Let's do that. So downstairs bathroom, hall bathroom, this will be the flooring, shower walls will be a white 12 by 24 matte finish, and then shampoo niche, we'll pop that in.
Perfect. Okay, so these are all HOA approved colors. It's nothing too crazy, which I think is a good thing because there's a lot going on here. So this is like a grayish. This would be for the body of the house. There's a white trim and then a pop of color for the front door. This house does look good on the outside. It needs a little bit of work, but in the end, I think the curb appeal is gonna be amazing.
It's a nice color.
The gray looks great, the white looks great. Door blue, and then what color are you doing this? Like, you can't leave it like this, it looks terrible.
Like a gray or something.
How much will it cost?
I don't know, as high as 2,500.
On top of that, this is such an eyesore. The tile looks awful. That shell design doesn't match with the house. Strange.
All right, so here's an afterthought, actually. You know the tile that we did in the bathroom, the really cool pattern one? Loved it, right?
Yeah.
We have some extra material.
We can get rid of that seashell thing?
We can come in here, we can retile the face with the same tile that we did in the bathroom, put a new spigot in. We're looking at about $500 to $700.
I think that's worth it, especially because we have extra tile.
Hey.
Hi.
It's a windy one.
Yeah, it is. Paint looks pretty good.
I mean, compared to before, this is way better.
Yeah, the fountain alone, that tile choice, looks so much more modern.
I'm excited to see this house. Welcome home.
Wow. The staging looks perfect. All the different pops of color look so nice. The beam wrapped in wood is a great choice.
It's completely open. Even though it's a tri-level, I still feel like it's a newer build house.
Totally, especially with the high ceilings and everything, all the modern touches, it doesn't really feel like a tri-level.
This came out beautiful.
It really did a good job incorporating the blues. It ties into the backsplash. Everything just ties in together, so nice.
Ooh, I wanna see the fireplace.
I like this room, because this really could be like an additional family room. Really pretty. I can totally see a family out here.
It's a good yard, I mean, it's perfect.
Totally.
Love the railings.
I'm definitely glad we did those.
Oh, this came out super clean. Look how big the room is. If we took away square footage in the bedroom by adding these huge closets, and it still looks like an oversized master.
I love the high ceilings in here. It gets so much natural light.
Here's the moneymaker. Oh my God, it looks so nice. I can't believe this was a closet.
Biggest shower ever.
It just flows, and I love how it wraps the floor and then runs up the wall like that. I love it.
It's very cool.
All right, let's get it sold.
Wow, this is such a gorgeous house. Oh, look at this fountain. That's beautiful.
I love the color of the door.
Well, I like how they have the tile in the front, like an entrance.
That's cool.
I like the geometric design of the backsplash. It really draws your eyes to the window.
This is pretty. Yeah.
See a few summer barbecues out here.
Absolutely.
Oh, so nice.
Cool.
Wow, look at the size of this bathroom. It's huge.
Is that the shower?
Oh, wow. That's so
unique.
It's a
walk-in shower.
Yeah.
And it comes up here. That's pretty.
Yeah, that's super fun.
Endless space. So much room for activities.
Nice. That's where you want to be.
We received some great feedback at the open house, and luckily, the high design paid off. We received an offer for $985,000. After closing costs and commission, we stand to make a profit of about $120,000.